Hello, hello, shalom, and welcome back to the Nellyville Podcast. I'm your host, Chanel Number 5, and I'm, of course, joined by my special guest.
Joey, what up, what up, what up?
Joey, so glad to have you here again. How are you doing today?
Good, good. Just getting ready for the day.
Yeah, well, I'm glad to have you back. Now, last week, we did some Reddit posts. We did some Am I the A-hole? And we had a pretty good response with that. I think we both had fun answering those questions and this and that and the third. So I thought it would be pretty fun to do a couple more of those today. What do you think?
Sure.
All right. So I found a couple that I think will really get the conversation going. So are you ready for the first one?
Absolutely.
Okay. So the first Am I the A-hole? You guys, look, if you're not familiar with Reddit is an app. It's kind of like X, but like on steroids, on drugs. It's a forum for you to post any question about anything. And like, you just kind of have it out with people. You discuss, you battle, you have great conversations. Not always a fight, but sometimes it can be. And that's very, very juicy. So anyways, with all of that being said, let's get it right into the first Am I the A-hole question from Reddit that I found today. And it is, am I the A-hole for telling my son I will never tell him who his biological father is? Would you like some context for this post?
Sure.
All right. So this mother, she's refusing. She's never going to tell her son, who is 20 years old now. Her son is 20. I think she's about 38. She's married now. The stepfather is almost 40, right? Maybe 40, 41, whatever, right? So anyways, she, make long story short, she doesn't want to tell her son who the biological father is because her son is actually a result of the R word.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So in her mind, she's like, how can I ever even tell my son that he is a product of that? I don't want him to blame himself. I don't want him to, like, you know. And
but he's at an age where he
he's very curious.
Yeah, now he's ready to, he's at an age where he should understand.
At 20?
The beginning of how he was created.
At 20. That's a baby to me.
18 is an adult.
18 is an adult, but you got to factor in a lot of things. Emotional maturity, life experiences, what has this child been exposed to? But I don't care how old you are. Are you ever really prepared to learn that you are the result? Your mother decided to keep you, not to have an abortion, not to give you up for adoption. She kept you as a result of something that was so horrific. I don't think that there's any age that you are prepared to know that bit of information. But also a little bit more context. The mother and the stepfather, they have been married since the little boy has known this man since he was 4, and they've been married since the child was 7 years old. They also have 2 other children together. And while the son, who is 20, has a very close, loving relationship with the stepfather, you know, he means no harm in asking about his biological father. He loves his stepfather. You know, this is the only father that he knows, but obviously a child is going to have curiosity about the biological parent. So what has happened is recently the mom and the son they've had a really, really, really big blowout, a huge argument, because she basically told him, I'm never telling you anything about your father. And it was a huge falling out.
But she should also tell him why, so that after she tells him why, then it's his decision to know who his dad is, or if he wants to. You see what I'm saying?
Right, yeah.
Hey,
my thing,
you know, this is what happened to mom, and I wanted to keep you because, you know, I don't believe in that abortion. You know, this happened for a reason. I mean, it should never happen, but things happen without your knowledge or whatever, right?
Yeah.
So now here's this beautiful creature that's born into this world.
Mm-hmm.
You know, creature meaning human being.
Yeah.
And
creature creation.
Now,
yeah, sure.
You know, I honestly think she should let him know, this is why I don't want to do it, but if you are still interested, I can sit down and we can talk to each other in a peaceful, calm way.
Yeah. I mean, look, as a mother, you know your child, you know what your child can handle. Obviously, that's going to be difficult for anyone to hear at any age, at any stage of life, no matter what the upbringing, social class, or anything. I think that the mother, you know, how admirable it is of her to decide she wanted to keep this child coming from with such a horrific situation. But I think that, you know, as the child started to ask questions, as they inevitably will, I think that she should have come up with, as horrific as it is, I think that she should have come up with, you know, I hate to say it, I think that she should have come up with some kind of story, some kind of Santa Claus fairy tale thing that you could have one day tell this child, because they're going to ask, especially a boy. A boy is going to want to know who his father is. Girls kind of can let it go a little bit. Maybe a girl would be more curious about a mother who is not present. But, I mean, look, your child's going to ask questions. And I don't know. That's a really touchy situation. But I think that the best thing that the mother and stepfather could have done is, y'all needed to come up with a fairy tale story. Y'all should have come up with a fairy tale story. Look, no one wants to lie to your kids, but sometimes a little white lie goes a long way. And I think it better to tell the child, hey, your dad was a soldier and he fought for his country. I think it's better to just come up with some story that you could tell him that, hey, your father died doing something admirable.
So when he finds out the truth, you want him to hate his mother?
No, but I think that when he found out the truth, that I think that he would understand why his mother lied. The world is not black and white. It's a lot of gray area, right? And
two wrongs don't make a right.
Yeah, but is it wrong? Not everyone can handle the fact that, oh, I'm the product of the R word. Not everyone has that mental capacity to be able to compartmentalize that, oh, this is what I'm from. I think you come up with a fairy tale. And if your kid, as an adult, keeps digging, then they find out the truth, then I feel like you just cross that bridge when you get there. But I think it's best that if you have a child as a result of either a one-night stand, an R situation, or some undesirable situation, I think you keep the fantasy alive for as long as you possibly can. Because what do you do with that information? And 20 years old is just not, I'm sorry, 20 years old is just not old enough to me. But also, I'm just thinking about me as a 20-year-old. But other 20-year-olds that I know, I just don't think that they are emotionally mature enough, cognitively mature enough to be able to process that without it being just completely damaging to their entire identity. And look, it's a hard situation. I understand why the mom lied, but this child is not going to let up. So either she needs to tell him the truth, or her and her husband, the stepfather, they need to come up with a really good elaborate lie. I don't condone lying, but what else do you do in this situation? You see what I'm saying? And for anyone out here who, you know, you want to know who your biological parents is, or if you are growing up in a single parent home, be very careful of what you are asking for. Because it might be a reason why you don't know who one of your parents is. There might be a reason. And that goes across the board with anything. Do not push so hard for answers that you don't have the answer. Push so hard for questions that you don't have the answers to. Don't push so hard. Because it might be a reason that you don't know. And if you're going to push so hard to figure out an answer to something, you better be prepared for any outcome, because the answer that you get might not be the one that you want or the one that you expected. So if you're going to go digging for stuff, digging through people's past, you better be prepared. Because you might find out something that you don't like. And I just think that at 20 years old, baby, you don't even know all the options. Leave well enough alone. You know? But I understand the curiosity. Look, if you're going to have kids in this world and you plan on not telling them who one of the parents is, baby, you better really think about that. Because if you think you're going to tell these kids, oh, I don't know who your mother is, or I don't know who the father, I'm not telling you nothing about your mother or your father, baby, please. These kids are going to have questions, so you better think about everything. Maybe just give the kid up for adoption. Look, I know people want to keep their kids, but it's easier to just give the kid up for adoption and move on. You know what I'm saying? What do you think, Joey?
I just flip a coin.
Yeah, it's a sucky situation either way. Anyways, moving on to something a little more lighthearted. Okay? So here's another situation. So this guy writes, am I the a-hole for telling my girlfriend that all of her guy friends want to sleep with her? Okay? So I'm going to give you a little bit of context behind this one. So this guy and this girl, they've been dating for a while, right? And so she says, hey, I would like for you to meet my friends, right? That's a normal thing. So they go out to this bar, very laid back, very casual, right? So in his mind, he's just thinking, assuming this is going to be women, at least mostly, right? So he gets there, it's all men. So at first he was like, okay, this is kind of weird, but like, whatever. So throughout the night, he notices they're making a lot of, they're being flirtatious, they're being physical, they're making sexual innuendos, all of these things, right? So the next day, so she's like, hey, what did you think of my friends? And he's like, look, honestly, I think they all kind of want to bang you. And I think that they were being very flirtatious, even with me being there. And I think that if you ever were to give any of them the green light, I think that they would take advantage of that. So is he the a-hole of that? Because she's upset. So he let it go because she's like, no, they're just like that. It's now
yeah,
she's.
But she should have respect. I mean, she shouldn't be physically or flirting in front of her man.
I don't know. Well, he didn't say that she was. He's. Said that the guys were.
Well, she should have stopped it right then and there.
Yeah, absolutely. But she might not have seen. But
come on, girls see that more than guys do.
I wholeheartedly agree, and I'm about to go in on this post. But the thing is that she's upset with her boyfriend because he won't apologize for assuming such a thing, and I'm just like, girl.
There was there to apologize.
Yeah, if that's what he saw, if that's what he's felt, look, ladies and men, look, understand this. If a man tells you something about another man, you have to at least process it. You have to give it the time of day. And men, if a woman tells you something about another woman, you got to process that. Because women know how other women think, just like men know how other men think. So if your boyfriend is telling you, some ain't right, you gotta listen to that. Because no matter how intuitive you are, you're not gonna be able to see what the opposite sex sees. You know what I'm saying? And this girl, she sounds very immature, and I think this guy should run.
Yeah, he's gonna get his heart broken.
Yeah, because I think she's playing in his face because you either gotta be really, really young or really, really dumb or really, really naive to, for one, why would you even bring your boyfriend around a whole group of men? Either there's some kind of a kink there that you like the fact of bringing your boyfriend around all these men and you know all your friends are these quote-unquote guy friends are flirting with you. Right? And you still brought your boyfriend around? It is either some kind of kink there, or you might just be a little slow. Because I feel like if you're over the age of 16, and I'm going to say 16, if you are over the age of 16 and you don't have any clue that these men are flirting with you or saying things that they shouldn't say in front of your boyfriend, And why would you take your boyfriend out in front of a whole group of men? Like, baby, they don't click with you? Like, look, I know I'm a millennial, and I know Gen Z does things a little differently. Let me see what the ages are of these people. What are the ages? Did he say? I don't even think he put the ages in here. But the point is, even if this is a Gen Z couple, child, she's playing. Don't you think? Mm-hmm. What are your thoughts on the situation? Like, if you were out with a girl, you go to a bar, you show up, and she's got, it's nothing but guy friends. What's your initial reaction when you show up to the bar?
Who's buying the drinks? Nah, just kidding. You know, nah. I don't know. I mean, honestly, people can have friends, but there's a limit to what should be, how you interact with them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if these guys are trying to get in your pants, then you shouldn't be their friends. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because that's going to lead to something different. And your relationship is not going to work out, because you're going to always argue about these situations.
Yeah.
So why not just get, either if you like the person, or if you love the person, or you want to be with the person for a long period of time, forever, or whatever they call it, you have to be willing to sacrifice.
Well, and also my question is, why does this girl have all male friends? Like, look, I am certainly someone.
Probably got an OnlyFans club. I don't know.
I mean, maybe you should. I wouldn't put it past her. But the point is, like, look, I'm definitely one of those girls that I have more tomboyish ways. I've definitely gotten along with guys more than I have females.
Do you
want to
answer?
Oi. I'm definitely one of those girls that's gotten along with guys more than girls, because I do have more, I guess you could say, masculine interests in these things. But I'm not delusional. I'm not naive. I would never be disrespectful. I would never show up to a bar with my boyfriend and introduce them to a fleet of men, other men. Like, for one, that doesn't even look cute, okay? And I just feel like, you see a lot of times people say, never trust a girl that doesn't have any female friends, or a girl who says, oh, I don't like being friends with girls because blah, blah, blah. I get that to a degree. I personally, it takes a lot for me to call someone a friend. I don't care if you're a girl, man, woman, I don't give a damn. I'm not calling you a friend. I have associates. I have acquaintances. You know what I'm saying? Look, I believe in zero, one deep. You know what I'm saying? I have people that, sure, I'll go out with you. I have friends, you know, I might cut up with you on TikTok or Instagram or some or whatever. But to be called a friend? Nah, man, that's not no light weight to me. But I don't see any fault in female relationships. And I do think that it is a red flag. If you have a girl and all she has is male friends, especially over a certain age, if you're over the age of like 22, 23, and all you have is, if you're a woman and all you have is men friends, you don't have any female relationship, you don't have any successful female relationships, and you're a girl, baby, you might be the problem.
Yeah.
You might be the problem. But yeah, it's something there. And for her to be so defensive and so like, why would you say that? You know, girl, look in the mirror, sit down and reflect. You know that shit is true. Mm-hmm. You're looking for something that you're missing. You like all this male attention. You like all these compliments and stuff. And you doubt that your boyfriend was going to be stupid enough to not see it. Girl, baby, he ain't dumb. But also, sometimes it's things that you're not going to see. So that's what I'm saying. It goes both ways.
Yeah.
If your woman is telling you, hey, she wants you, and you don't see it as a man, you better listen to your woman. I mean, unless it's not a long-term thing, then, you know, whatever. But if it's a long-term relationship, if your boyfriend, girlfriend, or fiance or whatever is telling you something, you got to at least examine it. Now, I don't condone people telling people what to do with their life. Because there's a thin line between constructive critiques and just plain up jealousy. Don't let someone take control of your life. If you dating a jealous person and they want to cut you off from all your friends, male or female, and they're trying to control you, that's something different.
Bye, bye, bye.
Yeah. So you got to listen. Me personally, I don't believe in male-female relationships. Do I think that men and women can be friends platonically? Sure. Do I think it's worth the risk? No. If you are in a relationship, if you are married, I don't think it is worth the risk to maintain an opposite sex relationship. I think it is possible. I think men and women can be best friends, our friends, or be cordial. But at the end of the day, biology does not lie. Somebody's going to catch feelings for somebody. And just because you don't, doesn't mean that the other person feels the same way. So to me, I just feel like if you're in a committed relationship, I feel like female-male relationships, they just got to cease to a halt. What do you think?
Absolutely.
Would you care to elaborate on anything?
Yes, just too much. I don't know. If you're in a relationship, you let the other person know what you're doing completely, where you're at. It's called trust, right?
Yeah.
I mean, if there is nothing between you and that other person, and you know, like, that your significant other knows where you're at, what you're doing. I mean, you can pop up at any time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So therefore, I mean, I have friends that are like females, but they're just my friends. And you know, all of my people that I only talk to, you know what I'm saying? But yeah. I don't go and hang out with them without you. Or I mean, we don't.
But I mean, but in that regard, you've never hung out with them. And anybody that I've ever said, I don't know, dog, she kind of, I don't know, mate. You would listen. You listen to me. You acknowledge me. So at least you were like, my thing that I respect about you is like, you like, if I spot something, if I see something, you'll be like, okay, I respect you. I see you. I hear you. I don't really know about her, but if you saw something, I'm gonna trust you. I'm gonna believe you. But you never have you ever been like, oh, I'm about to go have lunch with so and so, or I'm about to go hang out with Shawty. Or there's never been none of that. So we have a good rapport with that.
But I'm not saying everybody does. So at the end of the day,
yeah, some people be like, man, you don't know what you're talking about, and I'm gonna keep talking.
People are gonna do what they wanna do in general.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you see, that's what I'm saying, where if you respect someone, you respect their words, you take knowledge of it, and then you do what is necessary at the end of the day. Either you want to be in the relationship or you don't.
Exactly. You gotta place value on the relationship. If you are in a long-term, at least trying to pursue a long-term relationship, you gotta ask yourself, okay, is this friendship or this somebody that I knew from 5-10 years ago, is it worth me holding on to them if it's making my significant other uncomfortable? And if you're in a situation where you tell your significant other like, this person is flirting with you, I don't like them, and your significant other just kind of ignores them, like, man, whatever, you don't have to worry about them, then baby, leave, because I don't have time for that.
Don't you know no good?
Yeah, like, I'm like, if you know that you're not a jealous person, if you're not insecure, and if you just feel like your significant other is just naive and they just not picking up on the signs, and they don't respect you enough to like, hey, I'm telling you what I see, and they don't want to hear what you're saying, then baby, move on. I don't have time for that. I don't have time to that's right. And I don't have time to sit up here and tell somebody like, something ain't right with you, and you're not going to pay attention to me, baby. I ain't got time for it. But Anyways, with all that being said, these two posts can be found on Reddit. If y'all want the full thread of what everyone else commented, I can link it down below. I can send the link to you. But before we close out, Joey, I would like to say, what is the song of the week? Did you come up with it? Because you know it's your homework. You're supposed to be coming up with a song of the week or whatever. So, like, what's the song?
I didn't know you could speak a different language.
Whatever. Come on. What's the song of the week?
What is the song of the week?
Oh, you're slacking.
21 Savage.
Oh. 21 Savage, which one?
What's that one song?
Oh, here we go.
All My Savages, right? Is that the...
All My Savages? Is that what it is?
No, it's just My Savages.
My Savages by 21 Savage.
Yeah.
Are you sure that's what it is?
I think so.
Lord have mercy. Okay, so y'all heard it here first. 21 Savage, My Savages, or All My... Something's going to play. Thank you so much, guys, for listening today. There's going to be some sort of 21 Savage song playing at the end of this. I like 21 Savage, but I'm not that familiar with his discography.
Sorry, it's Future, My Savages.
Lord have mercy. Is 21 Savage even on the song?
No.
Lord have mercy. Never. Oh, so sorry to this man. R.I.P. 21 Savage. I'm so sorry, baby. You might get a feature on a future episode, but baby, this is not your week. This week is for Future. And what is the song called?
My Savages.
My Savages. Lord have mercy. Oh, 21. We so sorry. 21. Joey is telling me to take this part out. We may or may not have this part in. We will see. But yeah, we all for the future. You know what I'm saying? We all in the future. Sorry, it turns into New Orleans. I was supposed to be in Atlanta. Anyway, so it's Future.
My Savages.
My Savages. Okay, y'all heard it here first. Thank y'all so much for listening to us today. If you want to keep the conversation going, please come find us on all of our other social media, which will be linked down below wherever you are listening to this podcast. Give us a little 5-star review. Leave us a little comment wherever you are listening. If there is a comment section or a review or a rating section, like, do that for us because it helps us so much. You know what I mean?
Thank you very much.
But anyways, we love you so much, okay? Goodbye!
Bye-bye! Yay. You know
what I'm saying? Real talk. My savages, my savages, my savages. I'm always dressing fresher than a mannequin. I grew up in a ruthless ass environment. I'm on the phone with yo, I ask him how to try.